Now we have Franz Marc, who's going to be one of the co-founders of Der Blue Reiter with Kandinsky. And he perceives humans as deeply flawed. Again, given the context of the period that we're talking about, the early 20th century in Germany, that's not a surprising conclusion to come to. Now, he focuses on color and develops ideas of color as a reflection of feeling or idea. Very similar to what we've seen from the Fauves and arguably some of the post-impressionists. So, going down a well-trodden road. But he creates a very famous piece, Fate of the Animals. So the question is, how do you even begin to approach the work? Well, first we have to understand the right side of the piece is damaged and was damaged during a documented period, basically water damage. You can see the edge here. So this whole area has been damaged, and it's been restored as best possible, but we get these darkened colors compared to the far more vibrant colors that we see throughout the rest of the piece. And here's an idea of what it would have looked like without the damage. This is obviously a reproduction of the original. And it shows some apocalyptic event destroying both the animals and the forest. So here the animals are trapped in the forest, or seem to be trapped in the forest, and there's a lot of threat going on, a lot of things going on. And this is Marc reflecting on society at the time, that there's a lot of innocence that could die in whatever's coming. Remember this sort of impending doom that is washing over Europe at the time. And by the way, the same impending doom that is going to show up in a certain British private's journal that will eventually be published as he writes out those stories based on World War I, based on this environment. And that person is Tolkien. He will write The Hobbit and The Lord of the Rings based on society around World War I. Just to give you an idea of that culture. So we see this apocalyptic event. We see the animals trapped in the forest. Some of them who appear to have already been killed somehow. So this deer with its neck up looks like it's been stabbed. We just don't see the wound yet. Here we have animals that seem to be fighting each other as they try to run away. Here we have animals that may have given up and others who may be threatening. We're not entirely sure. They may also be deer. It kind of depends on the way that that area is reproduced and the colors that are used. The scene is intentionally shattered and distorted to reflect a sense of impending cataclysm. So what I've done here is you take the image and you take it apart, you take the predominant lines, and I'm just showing you the predominant lines on the left. And these angles, the use of these crossing angles, is giving us a sense of cataclysm, of so much action that it's actually overwhelming. And from a design perspective, this is brilliant if you're trying to get across this incredible chaos and cacophony of what must be going on in these woods. And we see a use of color. He's using colors that get across an idea of severity, of brutality. He's using these bright, vibrant colors. There is no mixing of the colors. So we get this sense that the animals were happy, but something incredibly cataclysmic is happening. We get the sense that the blues and the greens are animals that are in their natural state. And the red is this outside force, and the orange is this outside force coming in, hurting the animals or damaging the landscape. The artist learned the truth of this work the following year when Franz Marc goes to the front. This piece will later be considered to be a premonition of the war. And Marc himself described the work as his contempt for people's inhumanity, for people's willingness to kill one another, to kill the things around them. And that sort of lack of soul, that sort of lack of purpose that, again, we've had with Kirchner in the middle class that we've had with Noel looking at passion and spirituality. They're all looking at something missing in society. So we're getting the same sense here with Mark. Unfortunately, his career is cut short in service in 1916.